Hi, I'm David Cowan. Today, my partner Tess and I will tell you how Bessemer's deep tech team invests in companies to advance the fields of aerospace, quantum computing, and sustainable agriculture. While Bessemer's funded biotech startups since 1986, we mostly avoided other kinds of scientific risk in the portfolio until about 2010. That's when we funded Skybox Imaging, a satellite constellation startup out of Stanford that in 2015 became the first successful venture exit in what's now commonly called the new space economy. Skybox's constellation of cheap microsats made from cell phone parts disrupted the traditional model for commercializing space with billion-dollar satellites designed for 30-year missions. So Skybox wasn't just groundbreaking, it was space-breaking. That successful investment emboldened Bessemer to continue betting on world-class scientists tackling deep tech challenges. We recruited our own space experts to develop what we now call Bessemer's deep tech team. My partners include Dr. Ray Johnson, a PhD in electrical engineering and former CTO of Lockheed Martin, former Deputy NASA Administrator Lori Garver, and Tess Hatch, an aerospace engineer from Stanford and SpaceX.
Together, we've mapped out opportunities for space startups to commercialize and colonize terrestrial orbits, the moon, asteroids, and planets in our solar system. Since Skybox, we've made three other early-stage space investments in the areas of materials, launch, and fleet operators. A key driver of the new space economy is additive manufacturing, a technology that enables 3D printing of rocket engine parts that are faster to design, more complex, and higher performing than conventionally machined parts. To lead this change in rocket engine design, Bessemer funded Velo3D, the most advanced 3D metal printer in the world, now used by almost all the new rocket companies. Recently, Velo3D went public via a SPAC.
3D printing is enabling a new generation of smaller, cheaper rockets designed to replace the enormous, slow-to-build, expensive spacecraft of the Apollo age. As all space infrastructure shifts toward constellations of microsats, operators need these smaller, frequently launched rockets to continuously deploy and replenish their satellites, delivering each one to a specific position at a specific altitude and a precise inclination. In 2016, Bessemer surveyed the rocket startups getting started to do this, and we bet on a little company in New Zealand that had developed the first hybrid rocket engine that uses batteries instead of a rocket fuel engine to fill the combustion chamber. We were highly impressed by Rocket Lab's diverse team of rising stars from various fields who had come to Auckland from around the world to join in this exciting project. Rocket Lab also developed the world's only private launch range, situated on a remote cliff of New Zealand's North Island, from which Rocket Lab could launch every day. Rocket Lab's first launch made it to space, and the company has since completed 20 successful missions, delivering over 100 satellites to orbit on behalf of governments, commercial customers, and universities. Rocket Lab's current manifest includes missions to lunar orbit, the Venusian atmosphere, and Mars. Recently, Rocket Lab went public via SPAC with very strong reception on NASDAQ. With better launch options now available, Bessemer bet on Spire Global, a startup based in Luxembourg, Glasgow, and Singapore, designing a general-purpose Earth-sensing microsat constellation, a CubeSat version of Iridium. Spire Global has since put over 100 satellites on orbit that track ships, planes, and weather. Our little venture grew up and now operates the largest multifunction CubeSat constellation in space, at least around our solar system. Spire is the first space company to build a successful subscription business with about $50 million of annual recurring revenue and growing 100% a year. This month, Spire Global also went public via SPAC and acquired Exact Earth, its largest competitor in space-based tracking of marine vessels.
As you can see, space is open for business. Now, before we reach Mars, we believe there is untapped potential in the stratosphere, which is why in March, Bessemer invested in Boom Supersonic, adding it to our aerospace portfolio. Boom Supersonic, designed, built, and early next year will test a supersonic aircraft, reinventing supersonic passenger travel. Boom's aircraft travels from New York City to London in 3.3 hours. With 1,200 viable routes to fly, the potential demand is $100 billion of orders over the coming decade. Boom has already sold down payments of $6 billion of pre-orders to customers like Japan Airlines and the U.S. Air Force, And right after our investment in June, Boom received a $3 billion order for 15 supersonic aircraft from United Airlines. In addition to building craft for space and the stratosphere, BVP companies are enabling the rise of commercial drones. As part of our aerospace roadmap, we're betting that one day, drones will ubiquitously operate in our airspace, preventing disasters and making our lives safer, easier, and better. You can probably imagine a world where drones put out fires, deliver late-night takeout, and inspect our infrastructures, such as bridges, railways, and pipelines. For all of this to happen, we need an ecosystem of pilots, drone users, drone manufacturers, and regulators to adopt common standards and technologies. Our flagship investment here is Drone Deploy, the market-leading drone software for enterprises. With over 5,000 customers and 500,000 job sites, Drone Deploy software makes it easy to capture, aggregate, and analyze information captured by drones. They have the number one flight app, which allows drone pilots to easily mark the area they want captured. The software autonomously navigates the drone's path above the area of interest, and once collected, the data is aggregated into a 3D rendering of the surface. Lastly, the rendering feeds into the cloud so that the customer can analyze the image and perform over 80 various types of measurements and calculations. Unfortunately, commercial drone use today is limited by the FAA, which prohibits drone operators from flying beyond the visual line of sight of the pilot. There is growing pent-up demand for a safe way to inspect long oil pipelines, deliver consumer packages, monitor agriculture, or use drones in many other ways. To unlock this opportunity and keep the skies safe from drone-related accidents, BVP invested in Iris Automation, a visual AI startup. Iris now sells the only onboard detect and avoid system for drones that detects and classifies other flying objects, determining whether an evasive maneuver needs to be made to avoid a mid-air collision.
As we map out the frontiers of innovation, quantum computing, or QC, looms large as possibly the most important scientific invention of the 21st century. By exploiting the counterintuitive properties of quantum mechanics, quantum computers replace classical bits, which represent one or zero, with qubits that represent both one and zero at the same time in a fragile state known as superposition. So a 32-qubit quantum computer processes all 2 to the 32 possible combinations of 1 and 0 at the same time. QC upends what we thought to be fundamental principles of computer science, promising to execute entirely new classes of algorithms beyond the practical capabilities of conventional computers. In the coming decades, quantum computers will solve currently intractable problems in logistics, chemistry, drug development, material science, climate modeling, cryptography, human cognition, and more. The goal of the QC race is to build computers that solve commercially valuable problems beyond the capabilities of conventional computers, an achievement called quantum advantage. To help us identify the winning startups, we convened a panel of BVP Quantum Fellows. These 18 PhDs run advanced research in the pharma, chemical, and materials companies who operate supercomputers today, but know they will need quantum computing to compete. With their input, we led the $79 million Series B round in Rigetti, widely regarded as the leader in the QC race among private companies, based on the depth of their team and the number of qubits they're able to entangle. Today, Rigetti serves customers primarily through AWS Quantum Cloud and through U.S. government programs. Rigetti, IBM, and Google all use well-understood superconductors to create the quantum state of superposition, so we expect these three companies to reach commercial quantum advantage before anyone else. If we're right, Amazon and Microsoft will need Rigetti computers to sustain competitive cloud offerings in the market. This year, we also led the $100 million Series B in Xanadu, a QC company that creates superposition using photons. Unlike superconductors, light can be manipulated at room temperature and promises to one day scale to a million qubits or more. Xanadu has already demonstrated the ability to stitch together quantum processors, demonstrating the inherent scalability of their approach. These two investments position Bessemer as the leading venture firm in quantum computing.
Our deep tech roadmap has also pointed us to massive opportunities in agriculture, where AI, robotics, and biotech can enable sustainable and healthy alternatives for our diets. Rather than try to sell technology to farmers, an old-fashioned and fragmented industry with no resources for buying tech. BVP's companies compete directly in the food supply chains to disrupt enormous commodity markets. This year, we followed the success of brands like Beyond and Impossible by funding startups who develop sustainable plant-based alternatives for meat, dairy, eggs, and even coffee. Black Sheep Foods is the leading plant-based lamb company. By a careful study of the scientific literature, as well as trial and error culinary testing, the team figured out 5 key compounds and fatty chain-based acid technology that can recreate the gamey taste of lamb. They launched in Suvla, a popular San Francisco fast casual restaurant, last month. Otomo Coffee, which produces beanless or molecular coffee, providing a sustainable alternative to the world's roughly 2.5 trillion cups of coffee consumed each year. They do so by reverse engineering coffee's aroma, flavor, color, and caffeine content, and mouth feel with upcycled and sustainable ingredients such as date seeds, chicory root, and grape skin. They built a vertically integrated pilot facility that produces 1,000 cups a day for less than 50 cents a cup. Additionally, they formulated and produced their own milk and chocolate compounds using pumpkin seeds, rooted in the same cross-Maillard reaction as the coffee, for a canned latte and mocha beverage. They will sell 4 canned cold brews, a light roast, a dark roast, and the latte and mocha.
Tess and I hope that you share our excitement for the ventures that BVP has funded in aerospace, quantum computing, and sustainable agriculture. With aerospace leading the way, our deep tech practice is not only driving big gains for the fund, but we're pushing the boundaries of science to solve major problems for humanity.